Okay, so good morning, guys. No, we will begin with our discussion on fluid mechanics, no? Hydrostatics, as we call it, no? This topic, no, hydrostatics, no? If we will check the word there, hydrostatics. So from the word hydrostatics, we will realize that there are two terms there, hydro and statics, no? If we split it apart. Statics usually, no? We refer to statics for those things that do not move. If they are stationary, we call them statics. Those that, what do you call that? Those terms that refers to water are usually called hydrogen. Hydro. So hydro means water, basically. So this word is referring to water. If you will combine the word water that are at rest. Or since not only that we will deal with water, but generally for all sorts of liquids and gases. So amana ang mga general terms ang fluids that are at rest. So parang hindi lang siya maging exclusive to water. So we refer to almost all kinds of liquids. Now fluids are materials that can easily flow. When you spill it, it will flow out. Like oil, like water, like soft drinks that are placed in a can or glass. When you topple the glass with water or soft drinks, it will immediately flow outside, out of the glass. Gases also do the same thing, except that they have distinct difference. So gases do not have shapes, fixed shapes. They don't have exact shapes. They take the shape of their container. They don't have a fixed volume also. So depending on the size of the container, the gas will fill that entire container. So again, there may be a little distinction between gases and liquids, but somehow they share the same ability to flow right away. Now there are liquids that have difficulty in flowing, like those that are sticky liquids. Like shampoo, for example, shampoo, when you topple the shampoo, it will not all spill out, because shampoo relatively flows slower. We consider them as viscous material. They don't readily flow. So viscosity is a kind of resistance in liquids. So again, our general word for hydrostatics are the study of fluids that are not moving, fluids that are at rest. Now, these fluids or liquids, guys, they have a lot of characteristics. They have density, they have pressure. You'll notice that if this is a container filled with, and if you are going to open up the sides here, if you drill holes at the sides, with this tank or container filled with so much water, like up to the top, you'll notice that the water will gush out on the sides. But the water gushing out on the sides will behave differently. Those that are drilled near the bottom will probably flow out the farthest. Those that are drilled somewhere above the bottom, they will still flow out, but they will not really flow out as far as the one that are at the bottom. So you'll notice that as we go higher in drilling holes here, the behavior of the water will now trickle or get out in varied ways. So again, we may probably think of that as pressure, and pressure is somehow related to the height of the liquid. The deeper or the liquids that are at the bottom will tend to have a greater pressure than those that are at the top. And I believe that's the same experience that we notice when we dive into the swimming pool. The pressure that we feel at the surface, near the surface, is not the same as when you dive at the underneath the swimming pool. If you go deeper into the swimming pool, probably you'll feel that on your ear. Maybe your ear will be a bit more painful when you go deeper into the pool or into the ocean. Now, all materials that flow and have no definite shape are called fluids. So no shape is, of course, for liquids and gases. we are surrounded by fluids all the time. The atmosphere is composed of gaseous fluids. No? What are the gases in our atmosphere? We have nitrogen, a lot of it. No? Oxygen, a huge portion also, but I believe a lot of that is made up of nitrogen. Have you ever wondered why it's made of nitrogen? Anybody? Why is our atmosphere not made of oxygen? No? I think since we are breathing oxygen, why is it not composed of oxygen lang? No? Anybody would like to address that question? Guys?
Okay, ang yes. Composed of different gases.
Yeah, now why is it that it's not made of more oxygen than nitrogen? Why is it there are more nitrogen than oxygen? Nga mas damo ang nitrogen.
Kaya ang nitrogen, sir daw natural gas lang, sir daw isang oxygen, sir daw plants daw more on plants ang gahatag kagasustain sa atin.
If you realize, if our air is made up of so much oxygen, then when we burn up, when we start a fire, maibwal na siya, kaya kung damo oxygen, because oxygen aids in combustion. So a pure oxygen will not really be good. Because again, kung may kalayo, dako lang kalayo mo. And again, nitrogen is used by the plants for its fertilizer, as a natural fertilizer. You'll notice that when it rains, ining time ba lang ang nagapangilat? I believe there's a natural creation of nitrates there. So somehow, nitrogen is brought back down to make the ground fertile. So it's used by the plants eventually. Now, fluids are substances that flow. They flow under the influence of external forces. The molecules of liquid fluids readily move around due to the weak intermolecular forces. So the forces of our liquids or the molecules of our liquid are sliding against each other. You can easily break them apart. Not like solids which the molecules are somehow connected by something like a spring-like connection. You cannot readily break apart solids. So when you try to pull solids, they return back. So somehow they have this elastic nature that you could not just readily break them apart. But not for liquids. The liquid molecules are sliding past against each other. That's why they take the shape of their container. Now in gases, the intermolecular forces binding them are almost negligible. So the distances between the molecules are spread apart. So in the kinetic molecular theory, all gas molecules are occupying the whole container. So they are so spread apart in the container that they take also the shape and the volume of their container. That's for gases. Now, due to the relatively large distances between the molecules of gases, they are compressible. So, ang liquid siya, ang tubig, hindi mo na ma-compress, guys. Maybe you can press it a little but not like gases. Gases, you can make them and squeeze them into a very small molecule but their pressure eventually increases. So, gases are compressible but liquids are not. They don't have fixed shape, ang liquids, but they are not compressible. So, but gases are. Properties of fluids. One property of fluid is density. Now, for example, like water. What's the density of water? It's 1 gram per cubic centimeter. I will know that it is water if I determine its density. So density is some kind of a intrinsic property. You can identify a substance by knowing or determining its density. So if its density, if I get a liquid and its density is 0.86, then it must not be water. Because its density is way lower than water. So again, density is another definition of density is degree of compactness. So let's say we have here an object that is compressible. We are able to reduce its volume, no, by half, no, by pressing this, no, napagamay ta sa from 20 na himo na lang sa 10, no. And then therefore you'll notice that if we'll determine the density, density being mass over volume, no, so here mass is 80, volume is 20, so 80 divided by 20 is 4 grams per cubic centimeter. That's the density of one cubic centimeter of this object. No? Now, 1 cubic centimeter, yade, compare mo din sa piyak, no? Ang 1 cubic centimeter. Yaman, no? If we were able to compress this material and make it like this, the density of this material is way higher. No? Ang iya kada isa ka cubic cm. No? So, if you divide mass by volume here, nahimo na siya 8. So this one, for the same dimension, no, the same size, no, of 1 cubic centimeter, mas bugat niya compared sa piyak. So this material is more compact than the other. No? Just like, for example, gold, diamond and an ordinary graphite. No? Manotice mo ang diamond is heavier, although they are both carbon. No? They are the same kuno nga material nga carbon, but one is crystallized, no, but the other is not. No? What happens to diamond? No? Diamond has been compacted. No? Therefore, taas ng density sang diamond. No? They may be of similar, no, nga material, nga carbon, but again, no, one is more dense than another. No? Now, a material that is denser than water will sink in water. No? Those materials that are lesser, no, in density than water, they float, no? Oil will float in water, no? Ano pa ba? Wood, no? Styrofoam, no? Sometimes they are used as flotation device, no, kung may malugdang, no, or naga pump boat bala, naga boat riding, no, or naga island hopping, I mean, no? You are required to wear some kind of a floating device, no? So because now again, no, that one, no, that you are wearing will eventually float in water in case of some, no, unexpected events, no? So density is one. Another is pressure. Pressure is determined by dividing force over area, no? So force per unit area is known as pressure, no? So if we are going to step, no, on one particular area, like let's say, no, the object is 30 dynes or 30 newton, the object will step on, no, an area that is equal to 2 cm by 2 meters by 3 meters. That's 6 square meters, no. So if you are going to divide, no, that area with the particular force, then you'll get a value in pressure. No? So you'll notice that the pressure will become higher when you have a lesser or smaller area. No? Now, we always show this illustration about these shoes. No? Let's say a lady is wearing a flat shoes and on one day and then on another day, no, let's say Monday, she wore this flat shoes. On Tuesday, she wore this high heel. No? Same lady. No? Now, if it happens that she's wearing these two different shoes, no, and you were on the same bus or on the same jeepney on those 2 days, no, dungan ka mo, sakay ka mo, no, sa jeepney, and then she passed by you, kag nalapakan niya tiil mo, no, Monday nalapakan niya imo tiil, pag next day naman Tuesday nalapakan niya naman liwa tiil mo, no. So this lady now maybe, no, basically dali siya all the time, and for some unlucky, no, chance na ikaw gid pirmi na lapakan niya, no. Now on what day, no, will you really feel, no, so much pain on the Monday when she's wearing these flat shoes or on Tuesday when she's wearing this high heel?
Tuesday.
Naa masakit sa Tuesday.
Pointed,
kaya ang area sang iya sapatos, the area of the shoe here, no, sa iya nga ginalapakan is much smaller, therefore the pressure here will be much higher, no. A needle that is used, no, to inject probably a vaccine, no, if it's going to be a very big needle, then medyo yawa na sila padulot sa imo butkon, no? But if the needle is so small, very tiny, then it's very easy to inject siguro, no? It can easily penetrate your skin, no? Again, no? Talking about pressure. So pressure is affected by area, no? The smaller is the area, the higher eventually is the pressure, no? So the bigger area means lesser pressure, no? Okay? Do you follow? So area is determined by multiplying the length and the width here, no? And then dividing the force or the weight by a given area gives you now your pressure. But one common unit now, if you are using force, which is expressed in Newton, and area, which is expressed in meter square, Newton per meter square is a unit called Pascal. No? Okay, so I'm not sure, no? Maybe we can have here. So if the force here is in Newton and area is in meter square, then you can have, no? A value pressure in Pascal. Okay, now here are some conversions. And if you have a column of liquid, no, so this is a container, how do you get the pressure at some specific height? No? You can get that now by simply multiplying the height of the liquid, the density of the liquid inside. So if it's water, then it's 1 gram per cubic centimeter or 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter, no? And the value of gravity, no? So MGH, no? Usually they call this as MGH because density, no? Density G and H, I mean, no? So if you multiply these three, you know, the height, then the density and the gravity, acceleration due to gravity, you can get the pressure inside the liquid. So one factor that affects the pressure is the height of our liquid. So the higher you go up, no, then the pressure at the bottom will become greater, no? The more that you fill the container, no? Here are some sample problems, no? A spherical ball of diameter 2 centimeters has a mass of 30 grams. Find its density. No? So if you will try to calculate the density here, no, for number one. So maybe for number one, no, our value for density is simply equals to mass divided by volume. No? Now how do you get the volume of a sphere? No? So volume of a sphere is 4/3. Then you multiply it with pi. No? I is 3.14. Then you multiply it with the radius. No? So you have to have your radius. And then you cube the length of the radius. No? So pi r cubed. No? That's our formula for radius. No? And you divide that to the mass, no? The 30 grams. Okay, can you multiply for me the value of our volume? No? So our volume here will be 4/3 of pi, which is 3.14. And then our radius, which is?
One, sir.
Is one. No? So one, dapat himuunta aton nga, I don't know. Let's just use the gram nga value. No? So that's 1 cm. No? And we cube the value. No? Anybody has an answer, please?
4.186.
So that's
187.
4.187. Then that's cc, no? Cubic centimeter, no? Okay, but that's not density yet, no? So how about the density, no? So density is mass, which is 30 grams. We divide it by 4.187 cc. Okay, so the density now is
7.165.
Gram, no? Gram and cubic centimeter, no? So, what can you say about this object? Is this heavier than water or lighter than water? So our density of water, no? Density of water. So water na lang ito ni type, no? So the density of water is, so density of our H2O, no? H2O. So what's the density of water? It's 1 gram per cc, no? So this one is 7 times heavier, no? Now there's a value, by the way, that we call as the specific gravity. Specific gravity is merely, no? So let's say we call the specific gravity, by the way, as SPGR, no? The SPGR of water, no? Is actually, no, the when we get the SPGR value, I mean, no, that's the density of the object, no? So we have the density of the object divided by, you know, the density of our water, no? So again, let me just define it here, no? So we get that by dividing, no, density of object divided by density of water, no? So that's how we get SPGR value. So an SPGR value is the number of times, no, an object is heavier than water. So for this object, for example, no, so density of our object, no, so that's density of object over density of water. So the density of our object there is 7.17, no? Now if you have a unit gram, no, per cc, you'll notice that if you divide that with 1 gram, no, with the same unit, they cancel out, no? And SPGR becomes a unitless value because the unit cancels out. That this object now will be given a value 7.17, which tells us that this object is 17.17 times heavier than water. So if you place this object that we just saw, no, in water, this object will sink, no, by virtue of its specific gravity. No? Now, for those who are particular with what? With medical field, no, like sa mga med tech bala, no? They are at some point, no, probably determining the density of a liquid, no? Because our body liquids has a specific range of value, no? So if your urine, for example, happens to have, no, a lower specific gravity or a higher specific gravity, then it means that your urine sample is no longer normal, no? And it's possible that because of the specific gravity of your urine sample, that you may have some kind of a disease, no? So again, no, these values are determined in the lab, no? So, and they are an indication, no, whether something is wrong or not, no? So by looking at the range of value, no? Okay? So a tin can has a diameter of 10 centimeter, no? And a height of 30 centimeter. So maybe you can get the volume of the tin can, no? So the tin can is a cylinder. So the formula for the volume of a cylinder is pi r square h, no? So you can get the volume of the cylinder for number 2. And if you divide its mass, 2,400, by the volume, then you can get the density of the tin can, no? So again, the basic formula for density is mass all over volume. Okay, so ano na, no? I think now amo na aton nga basic concept here, no? And let's just move on to, and I'm going to erase this one, no, para we'll have a clearer image. Now, let's go to Pascal's principle. Now, and what is this Pascal's principle? Now, what they discovered is that now, if we are going to fill this container with some liquids, no, let's say we will fill it to the top, no, to the brim. No? And then we are going to cover the top, no, since it's filled already with liquid. We are going to cover it with some kind of a cloth, a plastic. We seal it, no, so that the water will not go out, no. And we will tap the plastic outside. No? What they discovered is that when you tap the plastic outside, that external pressure that you applied outside, no, of the container will now travel unchanged, no, to any portion of the ano na, of the container. No? So ang inang pressure na gindugang mo will now be added, no, all throughout the liquid. No? So since the pressure by virtue of the liquid, no, ang pinakadako nga pressure diri ari na didaan sa dalom. So if you will suddenly tap the top, no, ang dalom na di madugang na di siya sa pressure sa dalom. And therefore, no, usually the container will break, no, at the bottom. No, if you will add an outside pressure outside, no. Okay? You follow me? So tistingin na bala ang botilya sang kok, no, punon mo na tubig kag hampakon ang yang opening, no? You'll notice that the bottom of the Coke, no, bottle, na glass bottle will on some occasion, no, split open, mabuka na tong dalom niya, no? So what's the reason why nga dira sa dalom na buka? Because again, no, that pressure above has been added to the bottom, and the bottom already has an existing pressure, no? So again, no, the same is true when you have an airbed, no? Airbed is designed for people nga may ara na balang pila, no? Ang a pila or ang inang bed sore happens to people who are, no, have been lying down, no, for so long, no? Ang mga wala bala nagabangon-bangon, those who are bedridden nga mga patients, no? Now, if you are lying on a bed nga tig-a, ang isa ka parte sang lawas mo na when you lie on that area, no, for so long a time, kag hindi ka pag ipaligid-ligid doon, ang inang area will now encounter bed sore or ulcer, no? Ma-infect na siya until gid nga maglain na da sa sulod niya, no? Now, one good thing about airbed ko, no, is that the pressure in an airbed, no, is distributed evenly to the body of the patient. No? That's one thing with an airbed. No? So any pressure that you add outside will be distributed all throughout the body of the person. Kag wala sang isa sa parte sang iyalawas that will encounter more pressure, no, than other portions of the body. No? So less likely, kuno nga may ara, nga bed sore for patients who are lying in an airbed. Galing kayang problema sa airbed, kung sige ka hulag, no, ang ibang itong aparte sang katrin nag-saka na augman, no? Again, no, something about not good as well with airbed, no? Compared to those beds na may spring na bala, no? Again, no, this one is again an illustration about adding an external pressure. Now, I think Pascal's principle is used for the device na sphygmomanometer. Have you heard of the device sphygmomanometer? Now we are able to determine the pressure of the blood, no, or of the heart, because maskin wala na da ang sphygmomanometer ginabutang sa heart, we know that on the same level we can transfer that pressure na outside of the heart and determine it, no, by a device called sphygmomanometer, na. So wala, no, using the idea of the principle na of the Pascal's principle, no. Hydraulic lift, no? Inabalang may sa may mga kuan sa mga gasoline station, no? They also use the principle sang Pascal's principle, no, to lift something, no? Mga hydraulic lift, no? So they push this area with some oil and then eventually the car here is being lifted, no? So muna mga lifter tawag nila na hydraulic lifter, no? Uses this principle. No? Now, I just talk about specific gravity, and again, specific gravity is dividing the density of a substance by the density of a standard substance. Like usually, ang denominator is that of water. No? Now, if you have objects that have exactly the same volume, like the volume, the mass of the object, no, i-divide mo lang sang mass, sang equal amount of water, you can also get the specific gravity. No? Specific gravity is telling us how many times an object is heavier than another substance, for example, like water. No? So, a specific gravity greater than 1 would mean that these objects will sink in water, while those values, no, specific gravity with values less than 1 will float in water. No? Now, Archimedes' principle, si Archimedes, no, was the one who shouted Eureka, because he was able to answer the riddle, no, how to know the crown of the king, whether it's made of pure gold or not, no, without destroying the crowns, without destroying the king's crown. No? So what he noticed is that when you dip something in water, the water level rises. No? And when you remove it, no, eventually na manaog siya. No? So of course, no two objects can occupy the same space at the same time. So, however, what you notice is that the weight of the object in air is relatively heavier when it is in water. No? So when it is placed in water, it's just 4 pounds. No? But when you put it in air, it's 7 pounds. Why? What's the difference? There's a difference exactly of 3 pounds. Again, now we call that as buoyancy. No? Now, with that difference, we can actually get the density or the specific gravity of that object that you immerse in the liquid. No? So again, now that's using the idea of buoyancy. No? So si Archimedes, no? Anong in-shout niya? Eureka, Eureka, I found it. No? So Archimedes' principle na. No? Why does a boat float in water? And why does a coin sink in water? Is the coin heavier than the boat?
Yes.
No, no?
But, yes.
No, but no, it's not, no? It's not heavier ang coin sang sa barko, no? But it's just denser because it's more compact, no? But if you are going to flatten the coin in such a way that it will have a bigger volume, then it will also float, no? So buoyancy plays on the volume of the liquid, no, that you displace, no? Kung palapadon mo sa, no? So lang tawa balang barko, dako-dako siya, it displaces a huge amount of water. That's why those that you put in the boat will float together with the boat, no?
Sir, excuse.
Yes.
Admit ka na sila, sir.
Okay. Sino ang sagwa? By the way, may ara kita exam, ha? Okay, Dugay. No, bye. Ano, what time? Now, please text your name, no? Okay, I'm going to end now our lecture. Stopping the lecture.